Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome to today's video. It is all about what's in my hospital bag, or I should say birth center bag, since that is where I will personally be giving birth. I obviously, with going to a birth center, if you know anything about the difference, I won't be spending quite as much time there, so that's why this is a little bit more minimal and I don't have as much stuff and I'm not taking as many outfits and changes of clothes for me or Bella. So yeah, let's just jump right into it. Before I get into the actual bag, which is here, I wanted to show you what I'm planning to wear when I'm in labor, because I cannot find anything about this hardly online at all, other than you just wear a hospital gown. And I'm like, but I'm not going to the hospital. So I'm sharing this with you if you want to know. This is a black nursing tank, just a simple black nursing tank. Now this is not going in my hospital or my birth center bag, because I will put this on before we leave to go to the birth center, so this will be good. I have the nursing part, so I can flip it down if I want to for like when she pops out, if I still have it on. I don't know how birth's gonna go yet, it's a wild card, but if I still have it on and I pop it down for nursing or anything like that, it is good to go. And being black, it won't show any of the birth fluids that will be going on. So there we go. I have that I'm going to wear when I am in labor. I can throw a cardigan over it if I want to, or if I don't, because it's July and I'm pregnant, I won't. And then I have these little boy short underwear, which are super soft, super comfortable, super stretchy, which is awesome when you're pregnant. And then they have a little dip that goes down below your belly, so they're not too tight. I will also be wearing those. I'll throw just a little pair of like light cotton shorts or something on over these and wear that to the birth center. And then I will have that to be able to kind of comfortably like lounge around and in labor in until Miss Bella decides to make her grand entrance. So that's what I'm doing. Now onto the bag. So I have my bag already packed, so I'm just gonna pop it open and show you what all is in here and how I have it organized and packed. So I have everything inside of my Disney Dooney Weekender, so all of my Disney fans can enjoy this bag with me because it is one of my favorites. But I have it packed, and just off the top of it here, in case I needed it, I have, instead of a long phone charger, which you can do that too if you're going to be like in a hospital bed, but I will be a little more mobile, and so I wanted to take our power bank and a phone charger. That way, if I needed to, like if I'm playing music on my phone, or if I am needing to like distract myself, or we're watching TV or something on my phone as a distraction, then we can kind of move around the room with it and not be so chained to the wall. So that is what I am taking for charging my phone. Next up on the list is this little fan. If you've seen any of my other videos, you know how much we love this. This is actually my daughter's stroller fan, but I'm going to be borrowing it. It has three different speeds and is all bendable, and so I can put this thing basically anywhere in the room with me, and I can carry it around if I needed to like walk to kind of help get labor going again or something. Whatever the case is, I have this fan for staying cool, because I'm already so hot at 35 weeks pregnant, getting ready to push out a baby. I know I'm gonna be sweating, so I have to have this fan just in case. Next up is a pair of flip-flops. That way, if after birth, when I'm taking a shower, if I want them, if I'm like worried about that and that's like actually on my brain, then I have a pair of flip-flops. If not, I can just have them for like sliding on and being comfortable. I know a lot of people really suggest taking slippers, but I personally prefer flip-flops. I do not want anything hot and cozy on my feet. It is gonna be July, and obviously I'm pregnant and giving birth, so don't want anything too warm, so I'm going with flip-flops. Next up, I have my toiletry bag here, which just has some shampoo, body wash, conditioner, my makeup, things like that in it, and it has that ready to go makeup wipes if I needed to take my makeup off. And then I also have this Earth Mama Herbal Perennial Spray. This is the first time I will be using this. I didn't use it with my first labor and delivery, and so I'm curious to try it out and see what it does, but I have that. And then I also have the Dermaplast, which is exactly what I used with my first one. I know it works and it is tried and true, so I have a can of it just in case. My birth center does not supply the Dermaplast, so I wanted to go ahead and pack that, but everything else they will be providing. I do highly suggest though, wherever you're giving birth, birth center or hospital, check with what they will supply. If you get to take a tour of the hospital and see the birth room, know what they're going to have and what they won't. That way you can know exactly what to pack and what to leave at home. I have ice packs and all the different stuff that you need for postpartum, but I won't be taking any of that except for the dermaplast and the perineal spray to the birth center with me. And then next on the list is this After Ease. These are drops that you actually put into your water. I have heard nothing but rave reviews about these things, so I'm excited to try them out. I didn't use these with my first daughter, Lucy, so I am really excited to try them out. But they say the more babies you have, the harder the contractions of afterbirth and your uterus shrinking back down to size is. So I wanna have these bad boys just in case. That way it can help and calm that. Anything to make postpartum easier. Next in the bag that is postpartum related is diapers. And I don't mean for Bella, I mean for me. I will be wearing diapers, and there is no shame in postpartum wearing diapers. Now, I know a lot of hospitals, they have the mesh panties with the gigantic pads that will wrap literally from like your belly button all the way up to the middle of your back. They're like so big. But that is just not in comfortable to me. I don't like those as much, and so I have these that are the Always brand. I will have them linked and as many things as I can down in the description box below so you guys can check those out. But I am taking these. They were a lifesaver. I tried the mesh panties with my first labor and delivery, and they felt like they were about to fall off, and so this felt more secure to me. I didn't feel like I had to worry as much about it leaking because it's just right up there and secure. And hard to explain, but if you haven't given birth and you are prepping your bag, then definitely grab some adult diapers because they're the best thing postpartum. I never thought I would love an adult diaper, but here we are. Next up in my bag is my postpartum clothing little packing cube that I have here. I purchased these packing cubes at TJ Maxx a while back, and I absolutely love them. They're so cute and fun and perfect for having a little girl. First up, it has my robe in it. That way I have this just in case I need to wrap up in it, just to be comfortable for whatever reason. I wanted to go ahead and take my robe, even though we won't be there quite as long as staying at a hospital. I also have, this is the exact same tank that I showed you in the beginning that I'm going to be wearing when I'm in labor. This is just the Grace version of it. It came in a 3-pack from Amazon. They are a godsend. I will have them linked in the description box below because nursing tanks are your best friend when you're having a baby. So I'm gonna have those, and then another backup pair of the underwear just in case for whatever reason I needed them. This is my backup here. And next I just have my coming home outfit. I have a cardigan, another one of those nursing tanks. This is just the white one that I will be wearing with my supportive black leggings. I wanted something very tight and that's going to feel like it's like holding me in and holding that diaper on and all the things, because you do not want to feel like you're like falling apart down there, because sometimes you can. But yeah, that is going to be my coming home outfit for me, just something comfortable. We are going to be there for a very short amount of time, so I don't need a lot of clothes. So if you're wondering why my bag is so minimal, there again, the birth center, you will only be there from between 4 hours post birth to 12 hours. So I only have like that much of a window. I'm not even going to be there a full day postpartum. So yeah, that is why there are not so many outfits in my bag. Next in my little birth center Mary Poppins bag here is Bella's actual little clothing thing here. And so I have her little announcement outfit. So I have this. It is from Posh Peanut, and it is so, so cute. I actually got it off of Saks website, and so I will have this one linked. It is the pink lemonade, and it is just absolutely adorable and so soft. This is the first Posh Peanut that I've purchased, and it is amazing. So I have that, and then her little baby bling bow that she will be wearing with this. And so this is what we'll take her little I'm here picture with, and so be able to announce that. I have an extra sleeper for her just in case we need it, but there again, I don't think we will, but I have it just in case. And then I also have this little blanket for using to take photos with. Now this is where I'm going to ask you guys a question. I used the same blanket with Lucy when she was born for her pictures, and we used it as like her coming home blanket and all of that. Should I get another blanket for Bella so they each have their own, like, this is your birth baby blanket, Or should I be like, okay, we use this with all of our babies and just use the same one? I'm curious what you guys think, and I'm very indecisive about this, so let me know down in the comments if I should get a separate blanket for each of the girls. Next up, I just have this dirty laundry bag that I have also got from TJ Maxx. We have used this on a lot of trips, but it is coming with me. That way, any clothing that I have on when I am in labor, if my water breaks and things get dirty and things get dirty that I'm wearing in labor, I will have this to be able to put it down in and have something. That way, any soiled clothes are good to go. So I have this just in case. I also have an extra swaddle blanket just to, like, if we're laying around or having to wait to be discharged from the birth center, then I can have this to kind of wrap Bella up in. If we're doing skin to skin, I can lay it over her and we can just kind of cuddle up in this. So I have something light and soft. I also have this car seat cover. So if we needed anything like this, I picked this up from TJ Maxx. It is super, super cute. It is like the muslin cotton, and so it's very breathable and lightweight for a summer baby, because Bella will be born on July, well, she's due on July 5th, so we'll see when she gets here, but she will be a July or June baby most likely. So we have this just in case I need it to like drape over the car seat for any reason. And one of the last few things is I have a burp cloth. If for whatever reason we needed to stop and nurse on the way home, then I have this just in case. If we needed to make a pit stop, pick up anything, then I can whip this out if we needed it, if she spits up, whatever. I have this just in case. And then very last but not least is I have three of the little newborn Honest diapers in the little floral print. They are super, super cute. Have these more so for pictures. The birth center will have diapers as well as wipes, but I wanted to have these in the bag just in case. That way, if we needed them on the way home or whatever, then we have some water wipes, or if the wipes that are there are just not cutting it basically with if she has her first poop there, then we have these just in case. You know me, I'm a just in case person, so I'm taking these as well. But I only have three of the diapers because, like I said, they will have some there. Another thing that I will be taking but will be in my husband's bag is our massage gun. I have gotten this approved with my midwife, so check with your care provider and just make sure it's okay. But they were like, yeah, I don't see a problem with it. And so we're gonna take our massage gun. That way that we've got this just in case. I had terrible back labor with my first pregnancy and delivery, and so I want to have something to kind of help with that and not wear my husband's hands out. He spent so much time using counter pressure and all of that on my back, and so he was an absolute angel for so many hours and his hands were so tired and just cramping and it was bad. So trying to have kind of a backup to give him a little bit of a break. So I will have this linked in the description box below. It was only $30, and so that is an amazing deal for a massage gun, and it works just as well as some really nice ones. And so I will have that one linked, because anything to help with the pain and deal with that, as well as help our husbands out of not having to wear out their hands and their fingers massaging our backs. So that's gonna do it for my what's in my hospital bag, birth center bag. I hope you guys have enjoyed it. If you did, hit the thumbs up button down below. And if you are new here and haven't subscribed, hit that red subscribe button. I would love to have you join our internet fam. And if you have given birth in a birth center or have any tips on things that I should take with us with giving birth there, it is a little bit different than a hospital, obviously. So if you've been through that, let me know down in the comments. I would love to hear any suggestions. I'm currently 35 weeks right now as I'm filming this, so I have a little bit of time before I go into labor, fingers crossed, so I can do any last minute shopping to grab those things. So any suggestions you have, I would be greatly appreciated, and I'm sure the other mamas watching this, we greatly appreciate it. So we will chat down in the comment section, but thank you guys again so much for watching, and I will see you guys right back here for a brand new video. Bye you guys, thanks again.